This is the brand new Ferrari 488 GTE 4 R-Factor 2 in action. Okay, sim racers. You join me here for a rolling start at Sebring in our Factor 2, and we are sat in the virtual cockpit of the very first officially licensed Ferrari by Studio 397.
Still there. Right side's clear. Car right.
And it is, of course, the Ferrari 488 GTE.
Start's okay, you're still in this.
Crikey, the AI are more manic than a public lobby.
Hold your line. Clear left.
Right. This is only just a quick 5-lap race using just standard default setups.
Hold your line.
Just wanted to get out on track and check out what this new car felt like.
Car left.
We are, of course, racing against a field of other GTE cars such as the BMW, Porsche, Corvette, which are also produced by Studio 397. Ferrari has been sort of like the missing piece of the puzzle until now. So, what's it like? Well, first things first is it looks fantastic inside and out, which really goes without saying for modern Studio 397 content. And talking about the way Studio 397 go about their content, before we get too deep into the car, is it's nice that they produce packs and full grids worth of cars rather than just one car here and one car there, as used to be the way.
Side's clear. Car right.
Come on.
Right. It'll polish out, mate. Forget about it.
Whew. Right, this is not easy being stuck between these BMWs. Right, so we know the car looks stunning inside and out, and everything is highly detailed. It's all where it should be. And it's got the right sense of proportion and scale to it, so it looks really good in VR. In fact, R-Factor 2 in general looks bloody good in VR since they've gone to DirectX 11.
Okay, Jason, hold your nerve, just keep it smooth, no mistakes.
So, the car itself, force feedback is sublime. It's completely utilizing and tapping into the almost unrivaled force feedback model that R-Factor 2 has been blessed with. Now we are going around Sebring and my mic is possibly picking up my Aki force wheel, as it gives me a right old work over going around, especially this final bend. But I can feel every jolt, every bump, and every movement the car is making. It's coming straight through the wheel and straight at me. It really does make this car feel so much more confidence inspiring
Hold your line. Hold your line.
You can really start to
clear left.
Use all the grip that GTE cars produce, especially when the speed starts building up.
Air and track temps are decreasing. Air temperature's now 21.
We have got a little bit of traction control, but there is no ABS. But the amount of downforce these cars carry or can produce is you don't really notice the lack of ABS until you scrub all the speed off, and it's the last bit of the braking zone that you risk locking up. And checking a little bit of race footage and some onboard stuff, that is pretty prototypical of what would happen in the real life.
Left side. He's still there. Still there. Clear left.
So all in all, as a quick first foray out on track with this new Ferrari 488 GTE, looks great, sounds great, handles great, which makes it brilliant value for money at only £4.50. That Top Gear's a bit long, isn't it?
That's a new fastest lap for Solomon, 204.75.
I didn't play with any of the gears or anything really, I wanted to get out on track. Any excuse to race some GT cars around Sebring, and I'm there. Nearly went for a cheeky dive bomb. This is brilliant.
Car right.
Do you know what?
Still there. Clear right. Come on, Jason.
I quite often struggle with GTE cars and other sim racing titles, which is why I usually opt for GT3 stuff. But the tyre model and the force feedback physics in this title have really opened up GT racing to me.
Solomon is now
so much so that I bought all the GTE content that they've got. But I think sound alone has got me hooked on this one. Beautiful Ferrari V8 there, singing away.
Yellow flag, caution.
I love that. There's just enough power there that you can break the back end away. Not enough so you end up facing the wrong way, because the traction control will just cut in at the last moment and just, well, scoop it up as long as you haven't gone too far over.
Head is now 2.0. Fastest lap for Solomon, 203.89.
Oh, I love this final turn in R-Factor 2.
One more lap.
Should have gone 10 laps. Overcooked it. Oh. She has feathered the brake enough there to be able to scoop it all back up. This is what I love about R-Factor 2, is that your inputs, your decisions make sense.
Gap to Nino,
what you think you should be doing actually works when translated into virtual form by the sim racing title. especially using all the latest and greatest technology at their disposal in this new car. It really does just stand out. It's a beautiful piece of content, and I do not regret laying down my few quid for it. Price of a posh coffee. That's over and done within 5 minutes. Yet there's years of fun to be had out of this one. Love it, love it, love it. Links will be in description. If you love GT cars, you love R Factor 2, you're going to love this car. Simple as that. Come on, race to the line, race to the line. Nah, he's got me, he's got me.
16th place, that's the end of the race. We'll get next time.
Yeah, sorry, Jim. Too busy chatting. Oh, well, that was just a quick off the cuff race. Just wanted to, I was just overly desperate and overly eager to check out this new GCE Ferrari, so I just jumped into one of my favourite tracks, spun it up, wanted to give you my raw initial impressions of the car, and I really enjoyed it, really enjoyed it. Okay, well, thanks for joining me at this first impressions video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please like, please share. We love to get this content out to as many people as possible. As I say, links to everything you're going to need will be in the description. Oh, and as I bring it back round to the pits, all that's left to say is thanks for watching, and remember, always race hard, but always race fair. Thanks a lot. See you later.